to Kalles Crazy Drumedy Calendar. It's the 26th of December. Today it's gonna get wild because a guy called Robin Højgaard Jensen, he wrote me, hey Kalle, couldn't you play some Jodlebjerg as it would have sounded if John Bonham from Led Zeppelin was the drummer? And then he would like also a soft version of Det var på Capri, jeg så hende komme. Played seriously, but violently. That is such a lovely melody. Yes, Robin, that is very, very true. It's a very lovely melody to all the... Oh, my English is so bad. To all the English people out there, you know who you are. To and. Det var på Capri is a dance top song, like Danish Schlager music. And Jodlebjerg is also kind of Danish Schlager music. I thought it was a really good idea, but Robin, I have done Jodlebjerg before. I have done Jodlebjerg combined with Eminem. Check it out.
Yes, I'm the real Beaver. All your other Jodlebjergs are just imitating. So won't the real Jodlebjerg please stand up? Please stand up. Please stand up. I'm Jodlebjerg. Yes, I'm the real Beaver. All your other Jodlebjergs are just imitating. So won't the real Jodlebjerg please stand up? Please stand up. Please stand up. Jodler high, jodler high, jodler high, jodler high, yo. Jodler high, jodler high, jodler high, jodler high, jodler high, yo. Yodla hi, yodla hi, yodla hi, yodla hi, oh. Yodla hi, yodla hi, yodla hi, yahoo.
So I thought I would do Led Zeppelin meets Richard Ravnvald, Kære Lille Mormor. So that is what I'm gonna do. There's a lot of things to say about this before I play it. First off, Richard Ravnvald is really, really not good music. To all you foreigners out there who see this calendar and thinks, oh, Denmark, that's kind of a country I would like to live in. So, okay, one of our biggest Schlager hits in Denmark is called Kære Lille Mormor by this guy, Richard Ravnvald. And it's really, really bad, so don't come to Denmark. Secondly, the drums in all Danish Schlager music is like this. And if they play a fill or something, it's always just like this. One, two, three, four. And when I thought about that, I actually began to think about Lars Ulrich, of course. Because he's the biggest rock star we ever had in Denmark. And he was really a good drummer in the beginning, but now he's a really shitty drummer. And when he plays fills, listen to For Whom the Bells Toll. In that song, he has like five places where he can play a drum fill. One of them is this. And then he plays a lot of this. Oh. That is what I call a bouillon fill. Bouillon. Bouillon. And every rock drummer plays that, so that's not anything new or anything. But that is the fills that Lars Ulrich uses. And suddenly I thought about, oh, this comes all the way back because John Bonham plays this a lot also. But then he combines it with a lot of other fun stuff, but he plays bouillon. In the song Moby Dick by Led Zeppelin, I can't remember when it was recorded, but that's a song built around a drum solo. And that was, I believe, the first time that a rock song had a drum solo in it. So it's very, very courageous, very, very modern at that time to have a drum solo in a rock song. And in that drum solo, it's an amazing drum solo, but John Bonham uses two techniques mostly, almost only those two techniques. And the one of them is bouillon. And the other one is this. Left, right foot, if you know that. If you can do those two techniques, he does a... Well, it's a more bass drum, but if you can do those two techniques, you can actually play the drum solo in Moby Dick. And that just goes to show how long you can come with only two ideas. It starts off with, he plays with the hands, I believe. Like a melody. And a lot of like... calls one stroke roll. But then he starts. And the big ending is. So if you can do those two techniques, you can actually play the drum solo. And then I started to think about Dave Grohl, because he made a small drum solo in the beginning of a Queens of the Stone Age song, where he uses also only two ideas. The one idea is also... And the other idea is the fill he made from in Smells Like Teen Spirit. If you can do those two things, you can play this drum solo by Dave Grohl. One, two... goes into punk. Of course, he plays it better, but that's the idea. Two ideas, drum solo. So I'm gonna play a small drum solo in this song, also using only two ideas. And the two ideas I'm gonna use is the main beat in all Danish Schlager music, this one. And let's see how much I can get out of that one idea. And the other one is this. Lars Ulrich's beat, Phil from For Whom the Bell Tolls. So here it is, and if you want to support me with money to get more of these shows, you can support me on MobilePay here. If you have any ideas for what you want to hear to get on the proper way out of 2020, I'm going to do a big New Year's Eve show where I will take requests from you. You can write me here on YouTube. Take care. Here is Led Zeppelin as backing band for Richard Ravnvald and 4Jax. Check it out.
It was in Denmark, Lars Ulrich was born. It was in the US he became a star. Now Lars played mainstream heavy metal porn. He cannot play longer than one bar. Dear little Lars, congratulations.